Pretty cool, right? Let's get started. Hi friends, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Jeff, and we're all about practical career interview and productivity tips. So if you're a current student or young professional, consider subscribing for more actionable content. Today, I prepared 8 Google Calendar tips that will help you become more productive and share little known features you might not have known existed, but will definitely make your life easier. And for those of you using Google Calendar at work or for school, make sure to stick around to the very end because I have one small hack designed specially for you. As you've already seen at the beginning of the video, typing in cal.new in the address bar brings you to a new Google Calendar entry. This is really helpful if you need to quickly create an event, but you don't have Google Calendar open. So instead of manually opening Google Calendar and clicking create new event, simply press Command T or Control T if you're using a PC and type in cal.new to pull up a new calendar invite. As far as I know, this shortcut works for both Google Chrome and Safari browsers. And as a bonus, if you type in doc.new, slides.new, and sheets.new, this will actually help you open Google Docs, Google Slides, and Google Sheets, respectively. gCal tip number 2, and these get progressively more advanced, by the way, is to change your default reminder time to 2 minutes instead of 10. I personally found that being notified 10 minutes before an event really doesn't do much because I would have already forgotten about the event by the time the event started, especially when we're all working from home. So what you wanna do is head over to your calendar homepage, click settings in the top right corner or press S for the settings shortcut, go to settings for my calendars on the left-hand side, click on your calendar and go to the event notifications and change the 10 minutes to however many minutes you want. I've personally found 2 minutes to work for me. I see the 2-minute notification, I wrap up what I'm doing right now, then head straight over to the next meeting. Google Cal tip number 3. And this is a huge pet peeve for a lot of people. And by a lot of people, I really just mean myself. Your calendar invite should, by default, be modifiable by others. Let me show you what I mean. In the settings menu, go to the general tab, click on event settings, and for the default guest permissions, make sure the modify event selection is checked. This essentially means if the time slot doesn't work for the person you send the invite to, they can change to a new time without having to ping you and say, hey, can you grant me edit access or change your new time? And you respond, yeah, sure, hang on, give me a second. All that's just a waste of time. And even if you have a huge event with a lot of attendees and you don't want anyone to edit the event by mistake, you can simply uncheck the modify event option for that specific event. gCalendar feature number 4, the last of the easy ones and very relevant to this virtual new normal we find ourselves in, and is to display multiple time zones for easy scheduling across regions. In the settings menu, you simply go to General, World Clock, and check Show World Clock, and add any time zone you want. I literally have no friends in any of those areas, but one can dream, right? And as a bonus, you can enable a secondary time zone right on your calendar, so you can see exactly what time it is when you send the invite over. So I have a lot of meetings with my colleagues in the West Coast over in Mountain View. So I usually have that time displayed right over here along with my primary time zone. But since I went to school and I worked over at the East Coast, best coast. Before moving on to the more advanced tips, let me know if this has been helpful so far by clicking that thumbs up. And if you haven't found this useful at all, make sure to click that thumbs up button twice. Google Calendar tip number 5, add invisible events that only you can see. For example, let's see, daydream about saving the world. And over here in the visibility section, make sure this is free and default visibility set to private. And click save. Now you have a calendar event that only you can see. In all seriousness, this could be a reminder for you to take a quick stretch, drink some water, while having that slot still shown publicly as available to others. Tip number 6 is an extension of tip number 5 and is very useful if you have recurring action items every week or every month. For example, let's say I have this invisible calendar event that reminds me to write snippets every Tuesday by the end of day. So while I can choose to just receive a calendar notification for this important reminder, it's probably more reliable if I choose the email notification option here instead, save it, head over to my Gmail, create a new filter, and in the from field, type in calendar-notification@google.com, has the words snippets, create filter, and apply the label follow up. and create filter. So the next time this invisible event occurs, you receive an email notification. And best of all, it actually hits your inbox pre-labeled with the follow-up tag, so you will not forget to work on it. For those of you who don't have the labels and pre-label system set up yet, make sure to check out my Inbox Zero video for the full tutorial. gCal feature number 7, send a daily agenda to yourself via Gmail. For those of you who might not have the habit of checking your schedule for the next day, this is an excellent way for you to see your current day schedule at a glance. All you have to do is go back to your settings menu, go to settings for my calendars, click your calendar, go to event notifications, and under other notifications, select email for daily agenda. And now you receive an email every day at 5 a.m. with that day's schedule. gCalendar tip number 8, use advanced calendar search. If you thought Google search was the only place for you to satisfy your deep-seated need to search for something every day, you'd be wrong, because there's some pretty fancy search features built right into Google Calendar. In the calendar homepage, click the magnifying glass here to bring up the search bar, and click the drop-down arrow to bring up the advanced filters. And here you can filter by keywords, who attended the event, where it took place, and the date range if you can't remember the specific date, but you still want to refer to notes or agenda items from that calendar invite. For example, Tesla investment pitch meeting, Elon and Jeff, who? Elon Musk, obviously. That's weird. It must have gotten deleted by mistake. It was on there yesterday. That's so weird. All right, bonus tip. If you're using Google Calendar at work or for school, there's a good chance that you have a lot of contacts on the left-hand side here. And it can get pretty annoying if you have to search for one person's calendar over and over again. For example, your manager or your professor. I'm using my personal account here, and as you can see, I have no friends. Quality over quantity though. But what you can do is click on the three dots here and go to settings and change the name of the calendar to place them on top, since Google Calendar orders these names alphabetically. Now, you can go with the boring A underscore, right? Or asterisks, that works too. But what's fun is you can head over to emojipedia.org and search for an emoji that reminds you of that person. For example, money, money bags. Control C and Control V, and it's saved, and you go back and boom, Warren Buffett. Money bags right on top here, my super go-to person for money managing needs. Cool, please let me know down in the comments which one of these tips you enjoyed the most. For me, the time zone one was actually a game changer because I have so many meetings across different regions. Hope you found this helpful, subscribe if you haven't already, and as usual, have a great one.